Heart rate can be an imperfect stand-in to quantify stress. The greater the rise in sympathetic activity and the greater the heart rate, the more stress you feel. Slow, deep respiratory effort causes a reduction in heart rate. Doing this on purpose can make you feel more in control of your own subconscious response to stress and feel better prepared to tackle the challenges of your particular situation. The breathing technique I will introduce here is referred to as tactical breathing or square breathing. The skill centers around the number four. There are four steps and everything is conducted on a four count. First, inhale for 4 seconds, then hold your breath in for 4 seconds. Exhale over 4 seconds and then hold out for 4 seconds and repeat. The intent is to gain some control over your sympathetic nervous system that's being revved up, so the exact timing is not essential. Indeed, when you're stressed, it may not be possible. The first cycle or two that you do this, it may be hard to get to four. Counting to two or three to start out is perfectly acceptable. This is more about intent than perfect execution. Let's try it out for 2 breaths. Ready? Breathe in, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Breathe in, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. Exhale, 2, 3, 4. Hold, 2, 3, 4. I feel more relaxed already. Let's discuss some appropriate points during a stressful event to utilize controlled breathing. Even in healthcare, you usually have some notifications seconds to minutes before finding yourself in a threatening situation, whether it is a code alarm, a rapid response team request, or a heads up from your dispatcher or friendly EMS provider, you are often notified prior to stepping into a potentially stressful situation. Controlled breathing is useful starting at this moment, just before a stressful event occurs. Hearing that code alarm or your pager going off provides a jolt of adrenaline. At that moment, stop. Breathe. 4 seconds in, hold for 4 seconds, 4 seconds out, and hold for 4 seconds. Repeat just a couple of times. This will allow you to process the information you've received so far and formulate some rough ideas of differential and treatments. It can also help you remain calm as the team leader and signal to other team members that you are calm and things are secure. Take time to practice until this becomes your routine. In the middle of a stressful event, it can be difficult to have the mental resources to perform controlled breathing and complete tasks. It takes a lot of practice. But at certain breaks in the action, controlled breathing can help you reduce the stress that is building and regain some feeling of control. A great example of this is after defibrillation during a straightforward cardiac arrest. Fear and panic are contagious. Calm can be contagious as well. After that first shock, you have 2 minutes of CPR until the next check that you can use to calm yourself down. Controlled breathing can be equally useful after an event is over. Research has shown promising reductions in stress response, anxiety, hyperarousal, and even post-traumatic stress disorder. In PTSD literature, controlled breathing is capable of de-linking the memory of an event from that hyperactive physiologic state. This concludes Breathe, the first performance-enhancing psychological skill under Breathe, Talk, See, Focus. You have learned how controlled breathing can modulate the human physiological stress response, practiced square breathing, and identified a couple appropriate points before, during, and after a stressful event to use it. Next, you'll learn about the second PEPs, talk,